Everyone listening to me well?
Yeah, audio and video are both good, mate.
Okay, so let's start. So my name is Sandro Pereira. I'm a senior software developer and Microsoft Integration MVP at DevSco. I have my own blog. I do a lot of articles on it. I am also writing articles on TechNet Wiki and some of community blogs. I help in forums and so on. So I try to help the general community about BizTalk server. And I'm happy to be back again on Integration Monday. This time with the BizTalk NoS add-in. Much of your time showing slides. I only have 6 or 5 slides. And then I will try to show you real case scenarios where this BizTalk NoS Ultimate or add-in can help you increase our productivity and our experience in BizTalk server projects. So why this session? First of all, I was invited and I accept doing this session because I really like this tool. Okay, I'm not trying to sell you the tool. It's up to you if you want to use it or not. I didn't prepare nothing about this session. I only prepared the slides and choose 2 or 3 real case projects that I have. And I do that because I really want to pass the message to you why I love BizTalk NoS Ultimate. I didn't prepare any storyboard. I only have a few slides, and if I forget some feature about NoS add-in today, it's because I don't use too much. My intention is not to show all the tool. My intention is to show you the nice features I love inside it and why it can help us on our productivity as developers. I also had the privilege to be one of the first beta tests of this tool. This tool start with Nino Crodelli in 2014, I think. It showed for the first time in London event. I was one of the first to try the tool. I was the first to document the tool, so I have a good insight about this tool. And I think since last year, BizTalk 316 took this tool, improved, and is starting to create a product about it. And they will start to add new features. Okay, but mainly, I want to do this session because I really think that this tool has a huge impact on developer lifestyle. Okay, since I'm working BizTalk, I remember as a developer 2 main changes in this product. The first was from 2002 to 2014, so we passed to developing Visio to Visual Studio. So that was a huge improvement for us developers. The second that I remember was the BizTalk console, the administration console that appears in 2006. And we have a nice way to deploy the applications, or a better way to deploy the application. We don't have anymore the ports, the create the C locations, send ports inside Visual Studio. And I'm saying
Sandro,
that
it's just Mike. just spotted that your screen seems to have stopped sharing.
Yeah, really?
Double check that, mate.
How can I do that?
If you look at the top on the go to webinar like toolbar thing, there should be a big button like a play button which says show my, and you can pick pick a screen there.
Mike,
on air.
I think the screen it is visible, Mike. It currently says impact in the developer lifestyle. So is that the one you're talking about, Sandro?
Impacting the developer lifestyle, yes.
So I can't see it in the comments from somebody on the chat.
Yeah, I'm
happy to just trust it's a one-off. It's just me if the other guys are happy. I mean, I don't know if maybe people on the chat can just give us a thumbs up if who can and can't see.
I think it's all okay, Mike. So let's go on.
Okay, if you have any more problem, please stop me. Okay.
All right.
Yeah, I think it's just the odd user. So I guess if people are having a problem, maybe if it's not just resolved in a couple of seconds, just try rejoining the meeting's probably the best thing to do.
Okay. So I was saying. We had this new way to deploy the applications. We didn't have any more to create the ports and inside Visual Studio, and we have a nice way to divide the application and so on. So as a developer, these was the two main feature that has a good impact on me. So the rest was optimizations. Of course, we have now, for example, JSON wizard and so on. But that for me is some minor updates that appears in the product. But all of us comment and complain about the way need to develop applications inside Visual Studio. So as, for example, as a C# developer, Visual Studio is an awesome tool. So you have the class, the code, you can search, replace. If you have a class or a function, go to, and it goes to the code that you are invoking, and so on, and so on. The same doesn't applies to BizTalk projects. Visual Studio is an awesome tool, don't get me wrong, but as a BizTalk developer, we still have some things that are really easy to do as a C# developer, for example, that you cannot do easily in BizTalk projects. So search, it's one of them. Search for artifacts, dependencies, and selecting schemas. You all know that window we have, that little window with all the scrolls for selecting a schema, and I can go on and on complaining about some of the experience as a developer that we have daily, okay? Fortunately for us, BizTalk NoS add-in will help us in some of these problems. It doesn't solve everything, it's not his intention to do, but some of them, it will help us be more productive. Okay. So what is Ultimate? It's a tool, it's an add-in for Visual Studio that will extend with more features that we have today. So what is trying to solve? Hooking, for example, we all it's almost impossible to us today using Visual Studio to look for a specific artifact for a keyword or something like that. Okay, it's not easy to find the right artifacts on the solution. Dependencies. I mean, dependence in several ways. Dependence of artifacts, which web schema is used, which does the specific schema import all the schemas, where the maps is used, what kind of artifacts a BizTalk solution, BizTalk orchestration is using, which schema, which maps, and so on and so on. Also can talk about dependencies in the project itself. So there are a lot of dependencies that in the developer phase are difficult to see, to have the global picture inside the project. BizTalk NoS will help with that. So source code. I pass several times for this problem. Is the source code that you have the last code that you are that you publish to production or to your developer environment? It's difficult to check if you are working the last version of the code. If there is difference between the source code that you have deployed in developer or in Q&A to production, you need to compare. And it's not easy to do that at the moment using the tools that we have by default. Deployment, I mean, deployment as a BizTalk developer, not as a BizTalk administrator. We as developer need to deploy our artifacts to our developer environment. But because sometimes there are a lot of dependencies in the project, the deployment can be a little difficult to do that. Sometimes you need to manually do that. Other times you can do that by default with the Visual Studio. But sometimes it's a hell to deploy our BizTalk applications. And document our solutions. I mean, it's easy to work in a new BizTalk solution, but when you are migrating projects that were made by other consultants, other teams, you need to understand the solution before you migrate the solution or change the solution. And you know very well that documentation is always, if exists, they are not so good, and sometimes or most of the time doesn't exist any kind of documentation. So we need to find a way to document, analyze, and evaluate our solutions. BizTalk NoS will help you doing that. Okay. So I don't want to annoy you. I want to show you the developer how the NoS will work in Visual Studio. So let me change my presentation to my virtual machine. So I have here some real project that I have, and again, as I told before, if you are creating a new solution and from the start, from the beginning, I think, in my experience, I don't use too much BizTalk NoS. In that phase, I don't really need to use a lot, because all of the artifacts, all of the architecture of the solution is in my head, so I know very well what I'm doing, so I don't need additional tools to navigate in my solution or find the artifacts. In this case, this scenario that I have here was migrating solutions. Migrate is can be an easy task. So migrating a solution for 2010 to the last version is just most of the time recompile the solution in Visual Studio and deploy. At least 98%. In this case, was old solutions migrating from 2004 or 2006 to 2013 R2 versions. So again, 9% of the case, pipelines, schemas, orchestrations. You just need to import a new solution or migrate the Visual Studio solution and compile. Everything will work fine, except ADI or other strange protocols. But most of the time, the basic stuff will work fine. You just need to compile and deploy. In other case, for example, SAP adapter, you need to migrate. You need to change the schemas and so on. So in that case, we need to change artifacts inside your solution. But in this case, I didn't know the solution. So before I start, I need to understand the solution, what schemas they use, what are the inbound schemas, outbound schemas, and so on, where they are used, so I need to check where I need to change the code and so on. So in this case, it was really my integration with the system, with the internal system, with the SAP system. So I had my old SAP schemas that were used in the solution. I had here imported the new ones, so they are a little different, at least in terms of structure. But again, I need to check where these artifacts are being used. So one thing that we can do in this phase is make use of a feature called reflector. So if I run reflection on the project level, it will analyze the project, checking all the artifacts where, and also using the BizTalk administration console to check all the ports, all the maps where they are being used, and it will create for us a report, a simple report but useful in terms of readability of the project. You can say that is more like a BizTalk documenter, but with more information, and we can navigate inside it. Because I did that in the project level, it takes a little more time to do it, but okay, now it's here. Let me close. Okay, it will create a report with all the orchestrations, do that in the project level. But for example, we have this orchestration. I know that orchestration called ACK-IN. I know the schema. I can click and navigate to the schema, so it's an interactive report. I can check. the schema that they are using, but the the orchestration execution, what is the receive location that they are using inside. This is configured inside the BizTalk administration console, receive sub, you see, that's a receive sub. You also have the receive location name, what's the adapter type and so on. So it creates a nice report for us to understand where the messages are being picked up, in this case from a file, what it does, what the pipe and so on. So it's a nice report for you to analyze the solution. You can also do, if you have to work in an orchestration, for example, you can also go to the orchestration and again do a report. Reflector. It will create a report specific for this orchestration. And again, if you have internal code, it shows you to report your for documenting and analyze your solution. Okay. And you also can create this report in the, for example, with a map. It also create a basic report which are the schemas being used or not. You have two types of reports. You have the reflector that will create a project with all the some metrics, some where I've been used, the code, and you have a similar report called refactor. Is a more simple with internal and external dependencies that are being used in that artifact. So in this case, in this map, you are being used internal schema called schema ACK and two external schemas calling ADI DC14 and CSTAT 01. So you have two different reports that you can use with different information that you can analyze. But this is just for you to understand the solutions. For me, what really is powerful is when you are working in the solution, for example, now that I understand I need to change all the sub schemas, I need to see where they are being used. So what if you didn't have the tool, we need to go for each project, for example messaging, go inside the map, see if batmas were being used inside, no, so let's go to a different map and so on and so on and so on. I mean maps, orchestrations, pipelines, every artifact, I need to check if this specific schema was being used or not. This is a huge time consuming for me. So now we can easily go NOS troubleshooting and check for external dependencies. External dependencies is it asks you if you want to automatically open all the artifacts or not. I'm choosing this time no. So external dependence is which artifacts are consuming this specific schema. In this case, I have this map using the BATMAS 03 team, also have this pipeline and nothing more. For example, I know that if I choose, let me troubleshoot internal dependencies, I know that this schema doesn't import any other schema. So it doesn't have internal dependencies. For example, the same doesn't apply to the new BizTalk schema of SAP schema. If I'm going troubleshooting internal dependencies, I know that BatMAS will import the share types. So they have a dependency. Internal dependencies, which artifacts I'm consuming. The external is which artifacts are consuming me, the artifact. So I know that, again, if I go to external schemas, I know that I have, for example, this pipeline. This is a flat file pipeline, I think so. Yeah, is a flat file pipeline that transforms the SAP schema to XML. I know that the new schema don't need this pipeline anymore, so I simply can delete from my project. And this was the map that were being used. And I can easily go there and replace the schema for the new schema I need to import. I have the here. I think the same, okay. In this case, I had to add a reference from the new schemas project that I have. Yeah, inbound schemas. And now I can go to the map and change, replace schema. It's not this one, reference, SAP inbound schema. And I have the Batman receive. Okay, I know that I will lose the mapping functionalities, but I know that I need to rebuild this map. I just want to know where is the schema so I can replace it. Okay. For now, that's okay. The same. For example. The systat response of to SAP, I can go again and check for external dependencies. Let's say yes. So it will automatically open all my dependencies. And for example, if I want to go to the file in the solution, I just right click, locate it, and it select automatically select me the orchestration for me in my solution. I don't need to go to the solution and try to find where it is. So I know that all these artifacts are using. My schema. A nice feature also in this new version of NoSADIN is if I'm working on the orchestration, even if I know that this orchestration consumes my schema, by default, if you don't use this tool, we need to go to the message and let's presume that we don't have a nice names here. We need to go for each message to go to the properties. No, that's not the right scheme. So let me try again a new one. Which is my message? So is this? No, I need to change the scheme inside this and so on. So if you have like 20 messages, it can be also time consuming. This version as a dynamic navigator view. So if I click in my orchestration, I see that in a nice way that I have a message called mcstat and is from the type cstat that I'm using, the old one. I also can double click and navigate to the scheme if I want to see if this is really the schema that I need to change. For me now, let me go back to the orchestration. For me now, it's really easy to understand that I need to change these messages. So I can go to orchestration view, go to my message cstat and property windows, and then of course NoS add-in doesn't help you on this combo box, but I can go easily and select the scheme that I want to change. I can see all the messages, all the construction that I've been made, which type of message I'm constructing, if I'm using any a map. I also will see the maps inside here. I can navigate to the maps and see if the maps are, which schemas are being used in the map. I can see my internal dependency, also the external dependencies. For example, this orchestration I'm being called by this one. So I can go to the ACK-IN if I want. I think, okay, you talk with the BizTalk team, I cannot, okay. Yeah, sorry. So, this orchestration is being called, it's calling the other one. So, now I have a awesome way to see all my dependencies, all the artifacts that I'm using inside my artifacts. And I can easily navigate between them, and I can identify where the stuff are to change. So for me, this will help us improve our productivity. We will do plenty of tasks that were really time-consuming, just looking for it now in a really fast way. Okay, for me, this is priceless. Okay. So, we also have, again, I'm not talking about all the features, but we also have these heuristic contagiation dependencies. This will try by the name of the artifact to check if probably we'll have more dependencies. For example, in this case, the L4 will also select the ZDL4, but doesn't have any correlation. It's only the name. So it tries only by the name of the artifact to suggest possible dependencies that you can check. For example. Let me see. Again, I didn't prepare. I'm just trying it. So probably some of them doesn't work. Heuristic external propagation or internal propagation will select all the artifacts that are being consumed, and for each one, which also other artifacts they are consuming. So is a propagation of consuming. of dependencies. Dependency they will be selected. So another thing you very useful, if we are testing the solution, we know by the event viewer or the message that are being being logged on the administration console that a specific orchestration or schema has a problem. A schema is not found in your solution or is not deployed or something like that. So trying to find the right artifact inside your solution, you need to go almost traveling all your or all your solution to find the right name, and sometimes is not the right name. For example, the schema cannot be the schema name that you have in the solution. So we now have the wildcard search, and what it does is by a string that's called batmask. We can ignore case, you can choose open it to automatically will open all the artifacts that the string batmask appear, and we now can search. We know now that let me check here, I have a batmask here. Batmask also here, another one. These two doesn't have a batmask on the name, but inside they will have a message or a bar or something like that using batmask. And the map also. So let me try this one just for you. Trying to find out where it is. But I cannot. Again, this is not perfect, but is way better than we have today. Problem is some of dependencies that I have using the batmask, but okay, we need to navigate and lose sometimes, but problem is one of these that is being internal dependence also use the batmask and now is selected. Because I'm not seeing the buttons as a year, but let me but no. Yeah. Is there, believe me. So more. So this one is a simple solution. I only have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 project. So imagine that you are working in this kind of solution where you have 2025 projects inside the solution. So try to find a specific name solution. It's I only work in this solution because NoS will help me find easily the objects. I will not show you because I cannot show you everything that is inside here, but it's really difficult. Even the deployment of this project is insane. If I compile this project, it takes me 10-30 minutes to compile it. Imagine deploy and something failed. In terms of deployment, and since I'm talking about it, so for example, most of the project has a helper class with some C# methods that we can use inside our solutions, and we need to deploy these. We can deploy using, for example, our console. Go inside the resource if we want to bind this DLL in the solution, and we can, for example, right click and add the resource and add this assemble. This will install the DLL on GAC. We can also use the GAC util to do that, or we can now use the BizTalk NoS to just register in GAC. That's it. My DLL is on GAC. If I want to remove from GAC, I also can unregister from GAC. If I build, for example, the IOL processing, because it's referring some other projects, will also compile or rebuild these projects, and it will take more time. With BizTalk NoS, I can build this specific project more quickly, more fast. Okay. This will be very useful, for example, using this type of other thing about deployment is, for example, I create this demo. I couldn't show the real project, but I emulate this project. When I have a schema, orchestration, and a maps, these are common schema, for example. And I have a second BizTalk project that use that schemas in a different project. So in terms of solution deployed, I have two BizTalk solutions. The BizTalk project one has schemas, orchestration, and maps, and the BizTalk project two imports the map from BizTalk project one and only have maps using schemas from the BizTalk project one. So if I want to make a change on the orchestration that I have here, for example, let me duplicate this. And create a new port, for example. I don't care the names. Oh, sorry. I need to sending. Okay, finish. If I deploy, try to deploy. This solution will give me an error. I hope, because the schemas are also being used by another another application. So they cannot deploy the schema because another DLL is being used, that schemas, okay? So fail to add resource schemas because they're being used by another. So again, using BizTalk NoS add-in, in this case, it will help me because I can easily deploy only this assembly without deploying the schemas. I can do this because I'm using the orchestrations. If I need to change schemas, that doesn't work. You need to change the version. But in this case, for example, only the orchestration, I can easily deploy without any problem. Now I don't have this annoying error. And if I go to my orchestration, I probably, let me configure, refresh. And now I have two ports, okay? I had previous one, now I have two. And this, again, in terms of development, thanks to NoS add-in, I can easily solve this kind of problem. Otherwise, I need to deploy it manually using the console and so on and so on. Another thing is that I use a lot in my projects when I need it. Again, I couldn't show real case scenarios in this case, so I emulate a real case scenario. When I need to use a pipeline component, a custom pipeline component to, for example, change namespace or to promote something. And we know when you create a custom pipeline, you need to a custom pipeline component, you need to create a custom pipeline, you need to deploy the custom pipeline, you need to deploy the custom component to your environment to test it in Visual Studio. It fails, you need to deploy again and so on and so on and so on. If you have, like me, 9 host instances, you need to see or pick the right one or select all. So it's annoying, okay? In this case, I don't have this pipeline deployed to my environment. I did deploy the components, but the pipeline, I didn't deploy it. And now I can easily, without deploying from my environment, test my solution, test pipeline component. I want to test the pipeline component, I can test pipeline component. It will open a window with the instructions. You need to select an instance of the message, test receive pipeline component, and attach the NoS test pipeline to the process in Visual Studio. So now I go to my pipeline component, I go to debug, attach the process. It's the same as I did before, but instead of trying to figure out which process it is or select everyone, I now have these this pipeline, demo test plan receive pipeline rule, that's the name of my pipeline. It also, you can see by Convoy, Covi, BizTalk NoS test. And now I can easily identify the process and attach the process, okay? And run test. I hope it works. Yeah. So now I can debug my pipeline component easily without any problem. And again, I don't have, at the end it shows me the result if everything is okay. So I did change the namespace of the message because the original message was, let me see, have a pipeline. Okay, it's crazy orchestration demo to anonymous URL. So I did change the namespace of the message. So everything is working fine with my pipeline component. And this works for let me stop my debug, for receiving pipelines or also for sending pipelines. I can easily go there and test my pipeline component in the send stage. So it's the same, select pipeline and so on, and everything will work again. So it's really easy to test your components. Let me see if I, okay. So another thing is that I told you before is, okay, I did deploy a second version of this orchestration, but the original one was this. So imagine that, and this already happened to me several times. One time I couldn't have sure because I was migrating a 2004 solution to 2013 R2, if the code was exactly the same that was in the source save, in the TFS. Another one, I didn't have the source code at all. So hopefully I have the NoS admin to help me on that. We can, for example, go to this orchestration, choose jackhammering. We also have jackhammering option here. And what it does is, you can choose the development, testing, or production. Of course, no one have access from Visual Studio to your production environment. Fortunately for us, we can go to GAC, copy the DLL of the artifact, and bring to our development environment and compare, not with your dev environment, but with the DLL that you copy from your production. In this case, I'm just checking my development environment, and I want to it's not the application, select the application, BizTalk project one, orchestration, now it is, and test map. So I'm using this for the first time, believe me, because I had installed a previous version of NoS add-in, and now I'm working for this presentation with a new one. Some things are a little different in this new one, and for me is new. So this is a local assembly. If you copy assembly from the your environment. In this case, I just go to my dev environment, to my engine, okay, and select orchestration and compare or extract. I'm just going to compare. And it shows me that let me do it more calm. It shows me that my artifacts are different. The one that I had deployed in my environment are different that I had in my Visual Studio solution. I can choose a folder to extract the artifacts, but I can also have this option to extract, and it will save me. There is an option to open. Ah, there it is. Ah, it was different in the last version, so sorry. Extract, and it also opened me the artifacts. So I now have the artifact that is deployed in my environment and the artifact that I have in my solution. Again, of course, it's not perfect. I can go import these orchestration to my environment, to my solution, and I need to fix problem this dependency, because this dependency are not locally on my folder, so it gives me an error because this file is not bind to my solution. If I import, everything work fine, and I add the source code that I have deployed. This work fine, for example, schemas, orchestration, maps. You cannot make you cannot make everything, because you cannot, for example, export the source code of a map to a BizTalk mapper editor. You only export the XSLT. You can use it, but you lose the mapper functionality, the editor, okay? But you will get source code back. So this is really useful for checking, comparing your solution that you have in the source safe, but also, for example, the administration can use these this functionality if they don't have the completely sure if the environments are equal or not, even the production environment. So if you have like two servers, two nodes, comparing if everything is correct, the DLL on GAC is correct or not, probably you can have this mistake sometimes, you can compare it, okay? So I thought about let me check. Check hammering, dependencies, reporting, testing. I think I have it almost done. At least this is the main feature that I use daily in my project to help me be more productive in the in my projects. So I think I'm done and waiting for questions, doubts that you have.
Hey.